Yes, please. So what I'm saying, like PL SQL, it's a kind of programming language by the use of SQL. That's why it's called PL SQL. PL stands for programming language. It's a kind of block structured programming language. We are having the different blocks is there. Like we are having the declare block, we are having the begin block, we are having the exception block, we are having the end block. So we are having the multiple blocks over there. It's a kind of block structured programming language. Someone can ask me the question like, why even though the SQL is the language, why we can't do the programming with the SQL? Why it's required the PL SQL? Because SQL is a kind of non-procedural language. We don't have the jumping, we don't have the looping, we don't have the branching. So we can't do the programming with the SQL. For that purpose, we are using the PL SQL. Now, this is the first program that we are going to write. So I'm writing first PL SQL program over there. So how we can start, how we can write down the program, either we can open the notepad or what we can do, this is the best way to write down the program. I'm just going to write ed, ed stand for edit, and I'm just going to give the name of the file like e colon slash z1.sql. It can be anything. Now I'm just going to write down the program. So this is the first program, declare, and if I need to declare the variable over here, I'm just going to write an image of type varchar 2 of 20 colon equal to, and suppose I'm going to give like Santosh over there. So this is the name I'm going to assign, and the important thing is if I need to declare the variable, initialize the variable, we have to use colon equal to. So we are using colon equal to over there. Now what I need to do, I just need to display the values that we are having. So this is how we can display that: dbms underscore output dot put underscore line, and this is how we can display this. And what we need to display, we just need to display the nm, and finally I'm going to write and semicolon, and at last we need to use the slash over there. This is the required one, like always you need to put slash in the last. So just going to close this. Now my program is already over there. Now what I need to do, I just need to run the code. This is how we can run the code. I'm just writing at the rate of e colon slash z1.sql. So this file will get executed and we are getting the output Santosh. Remember, if you are going to start the program, you are going to do the same thing, you will never get the output like this, because before execution of the PL SQL program, one important line you need to write. At first you need to write set server output on. If you are not going to write this, you will never get the output. So first thing you need to do, set server output on, and then you need to execute the program, and now we are getting the output. I already did earlier, that's why we are getting the message. So this is the first thing that you need to do, set server output on, then only you will be able to get the answer. Otherwise you will, your program will get executed but you never get the values over there. So this is how we can start the PL SQL program. So how to start the PL SQL program? ED, ED stand for edit, e colon slash z1.sql. I'm just going to give the name of the file z1.sql. This is the file we are having. I'm going to write down the program, and finally I'm going to close the program. And now I need to run the program. How we can do that? At the rate e colon slash z1.sql. Now it's working for me. So this is how we can write the SQL program, PL SQL program. This was the first PL SQL program. Now once again I'm going to write down the second program. So here I'm just going to display. Remember, to display we need to use dbms underscore output dot put underscore line, like in Oracle, like in Java normally we use system dot out dot println. The same thing we are doing over here. It's a dbms underscore output dot put underscore line. This is how we can start the program. So this was the first program. Now again I'm going to write down the second program, ed e colon slash z2.sql. yeah, now I'm going to write the second program over there. So second PL SQL program. Now I'm looking for the user input. In any programming language, the first thing is how to display, and the second thing is how to make the input. So for the input, what we need to do, it's really complicated how to make the input. Okay, we are trying to do that. I'm just going to use the micro over there, ampersand nm. That's it. This is the micro that you need to use. Already you people are familiar with this. Enter value for nm. And suppose I'm going to give the value like ln. And we are getting the output like ln. Again run the program. At the rate e colon slash j2.sql. I need to give the value. Suppose I'm going to give the value like Smith. And we are getting the output like Smith. So this is this was the second program. In this particular program, what we are talking about, we are talking about how to make the input. For the input, what we can use? We can use ampersand. This ampersand is known as micro. So how we can run this program? At the rate, the name of the file, j2, and location of the file, at the rate, e colon slash j2.sql. This is how we can start the program. Now, I'm going to start with this third program over there. Now, the basic thing, like in any programming language, the most important thing is how to apply the if statement, how to apply the for loop, how to apply the while loop. So these things are there, and I'm going to implement all these things over here. So first of all, I'm going to declare the variable n is of type varchar2, or I'm going to put the number over there, n is of type number of 4, colon equal to ampersand n. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write the if statement. If n less than 100, then I just need to display n less than 100. This is how we can do that. Else, I'm just going to write dvms underscore put dot put line n greater than 100. And finally, we can use the end if. This is how we can do this. If n less than 100, then I need to display this. Otherwise, I need to display this. The most important thing is always we have to use the end if, and there will be the space in between. Always we have to use then. So this is how we can use the if statement. We can also put the multiple if else if condition over here. So I'm writing if n less than 100, then display this, else if n greater than 100 and n less than 200, then what I need to do, I am just going to write n less than 200. Again, I'm going to write else if. So this is how you can put the else if. Remember, in the else if we don't have e, it's not there. Else if n greater than 200 and n less than 300, then I need to display like n less than 300. This is how we can use the if else if statement. Run this. At the rate e colon slash j3.sql, I'm going to put the values over there, 3, 4, 5, and we are getting the output n greater than 100, but we are not getting the second value. We need to check the condition. Okay, just give another value over there because it's not satisfied the condition. Yeah, I'm just going to give 2, 3, 4, and we are getting the output n greater than 100, and we are getting the message n less than 300. So this is how we can apply the if statement in the PLSQL. Now, so this is the syntax that we need to follow for the if statement in PLSQL in Oracle. Now, other than the if, else if and all, we are having the concept of case statement also. We are having the case also. So what we can do, we can use case. So I am writing case n. Now, I am writing when 100. This is how we can use the case statement. When 100, then. What I need to do, I just need to display dbms underscore output dot put line. I'm just going to display n equal to 100. And again, I'm going to put the another condition over there. When 200, then we are writing n is equal to 200. Else I'm going to use n less than n greater than 200. Or not equals to 100, or not equals to 200. Whatever the message you want to put over there. So I'm just going to give this message, and finally I'm going to use the end case. This is how we can use the case statement. Run this at the rate, and I'm going to give 200, and we are getting the value n is equal to 200. Now we can also use the case statement like this. Here we are putting the value variable over there, and that's why we are using here. We cannot apply greater than 100 or greater than 200. So if I need to put all these things like greater than and less than and all, so how we can do that? I'm just writing case, and I'm not specifying the variable over here. Now we are writing when n less than 100, then display the message n less than 100. Now I'm writing when n greater than 100 and n less than 200, then display like n less than 200. Otherwise, I'm going to display it's greater than 200. So this is how we can specify the case statement over there. Like in C, Java, C++, we are having the switch case. Here we are having the case statement that we can apply. And I'm going to run this. Yeah, we are getting the value like n greater than 200. So this is how we can apply the if statement. This is how we can apply the case statement. Now we can also use the for loop over here. Like if I'm going to apply the for loop, I'm just going to write for I in 1.5 loop, and I'm going to display this like dbms underscore output dot put line. What I need to display, I just need to display I over there. And finally we can use end loop. We can use end loop. This is how we can apply the for loop. Remember, every time in PLSQL we need to declare the variable, but whatever the variable we are using with the for loop, we don't need to declare this. Suppose I want to implement this for loop in reverse order, how we can do that? I'm just going to write for I in reverse. I'm just going to write for I in reverse, and we don't need to change this like 5.1. no, we just need to use the keyword reverse over there. And now I'm going to run this at the rate e colon slash, and see we are getting the value over here like it's 1 2 3 4 5 5 4 3 2 1. This is how we are getting the value. So this is how we can apply the for loop in PLSQL. Other than the for loop, we are having the while loop also there. So we can apply while c less than equal to 5, and I'm going to use the loop. And because it's compulsory for me to declare the variable c over there, so I'm just going to write c. I'm just going to put the initial value 0 over there, and it's a c. Now I need to increase the c also over there, so I'm writing c colon equal to c plus 1. Always to initialize the variable we have to use colon equal to. And I'm just going to display this dbms underscore put line, and I'm going to put the c over there. And finally I'm just going to use the end loop. So this is how we can use while loop and loop, for loop and loop. So always we need to use the loop and loop. Run this at the rate. Yeah, so we are getting the values like 1 2 3 4 5 6. This is the while loop. And so this is how we can apply the for loop, while loop and all. This is how we can apply the for loop. This is how we can apply the while loop. One important thing is also there, like we can also use the loop and loop. We are having the another loop is there. It's a loop and loop that we can apply. Now here we can put the condition like exit when c is equal to 10. Because if you are not going to give the condition, this will be the never ending loop. So it's compulsory to put the condition like when exit when c is equal to 10. Now if I'm going to run this, yeah, we are getting the output like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. After the 10 it get exit from there. So this is how we can apply the basic if statement, for, while, loop and loop. In the loop and loop, it's compulsory to use the exit. If I want to implement the for loop in reverse order, we need to use the keyword reverse. This is how we can apply the if and if. This is how we can apply the if else if. and this is how we can apply the case and end case and all. So this is the basic components regarding the, it's a basic so construct.
Are we using the n number in the loop, the first when you declare the n variable?
Yeah,
like the n at the top when you do declare
no.
n number.
Yeah,
you are using it somewhere.
Yeah,
in the loop. Oh, only in the if else, right? Not in the loop.
We are using with the case, we are using with the if and if. We can apply anywhere, that's not a problem. We can display the n, and it depends on the requirement, like where you want to do this. We can put this n at any place, it's your requirement.
Okay.
Yeah, see, basically the thing is that you people are not the beginners, you are already familiar with the Java and all. So my objective is just demonstrate you how to use the while loop, what will be the syntax, what will be the for, what will be the loop, that's it. Now, so this is the basic construct that you need to remember with the PL/SQL. Now, I'm going to start with /j4.sql. The next important thing that I'm going to start with, how to use select statement in PL/SQL. How to use the select statement in PL/SQL. Remember, in PL/SQL, select statement can't return more than one value. Oh, more than one row. In PL/SQL, select statement can't return more than one row. That's interesting. And this is the syntax that you need to follow. Select column name into variable name from table name where condition. So I'm just going to apply this, declare. Name is of type varchar2 of 20. Begin. And I'm just going to use select ename into ename. I'm just writing select ename into ename from emp where imply number is equal to 7788. So for the imply number 7788, we are going to get the values for the ename, and I'm just going to put the value for ename into the nm. Now I'm going to display the nm. So this is how we can display this dbms and underscore put line. I'm just going to display the nm, and this is how I'm going to run this program. Yeah. So this is the important thing. Always we need to remember, yeah, we are getting the escort. Why we are getting the escort? Because for the imply number 7788, the name is escort. So you are going to select the name, going to put the value into the NM, and finally I am going to display this. Suppose I also want to display the salary over there. So I'm just going to use x is of type number of 4, colon equal to 0. And I'm looking for the salary also. It's not necessary to initialize this. So I'm just going to write select ename comma sal into nm comma x. Now I'm going to display the salary also. Run this. At the rate of /j4.sql, and we are getting the output escort 5000. So this is how we can apply the select statement in PL/SQL.
Sir, why are you using the slash at the bottom?
If I'm not going to use this, and if I'm going to run this program, see, to terminate the PL/SQL program, we need the slash. It's waiting for the line termination. So I need to put the slash over here. Then it's going to execute. So in the PL/SQL program, the complete program will get terminated when we use the slash.
Okay.
So I'm just going to use a slash over there. So this is interesting. And suppose do one thing, I'm just going to apply department number is equal to 20. What will happen? Will this program will get execute? This program will get execute or return some error over there? Because for department number 20, we are having the multiple record in the table. And my statement was in PLSQL, select a statement can't return more than one row. So of course, this particular line is going to give me the error. And what error we are getting over here? Exact fetch return more than a requested number of rows, line 5. So this is our responsibility. If I'm going to write the select statement over here, I need to check like how this is going to return the value. So we need to put over here like, so we need to put the condition in such a way that it's going to return maximum one row. 7, 7, 8. This is how we can apply the select statement in PLSQL. Now if I'm going to run this, at the rate e colon slash z4.sql, we are getting the message escort 5000. This is how we can use this. Now z5.sql. Now we are having the concept of percentage type attribute. What exactly is this? See, right now we are using an image of type varchar 2 of 20. Why we are using varchar 2 of 20? Because we are going to store the ename over there. I'm using x image of type number of 5. Why we are using x number of 5? Because we are going to store the salary over there. See, we are familiar with the EMP table. We are familiar with the columns and all. So already we are familiar, okay, in the ename there will be the name is of type varchar 2. And maximum size is 20, so I'm just going to allocate the 20 over there. And for the salary, I'm just going to put the number because we are already familiar with the table and all. Right here, we are just going to get the two columns over there. And suppose we are getting the 20 columns or 40 columns. In that case, always you need to remember the data types of the column and the size. So it's not easy for us to remember the data type and the size of the column. So what we can do in the place of varchar 2 of 20, might be the size is more than 20, then it will give you the error. So what we can do, unnecessary, we don't need to put the varchar 2 or number over there. What we can do, we can just simply use emp dot ename percentage type. What does it mean? Like if we are going to declare the variable nm is of type, what will be the data type and what will be the size? The data type and size of the NM will be data type and size of enum from the EMP table. So percentage type attribute is used to declare the variable, used to declare the variable according to the column definition. According to column definition. Otherwise, every time you need to check the data type and the size of the column. So we don't want to do that because right now we are having the two columns. Might be we are going to get the value from the 20 columns. For that, it's not necessary like always we need to go for the describe the EMP. Then we need to check the data type, their size. Then we will declare the variable. So I don't want to do that. That's why I'm using percentage type over here. Like x is of type number. I need to store the salary over there. So I'm just going to use imp dot sal percentage type. That's it. So this is what exactly the percentage type attribute. Run this program. Yeah, we are getting a Scott and 5000. Remember, one problem is there. Like how many columns we are going to select, how many values we are going to select. It's a two values. So we need to declare the two variables. Suppose I'm also looking for the job. Then again, I need to declare the variable. Suppose I also looking for the commission, Again, I need to declare the variable. Suppose I want to get the department number also. Again, I need to declare the variable. Suppose I am looking for the job also. Again, you need to declare the variable. It's not possible to declare all the variables over there. So what we can do, we can use percentage row type. Percentage row type is used to declare the variable according to the row definition. Row definition means what? It can store the entire row. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write an image of type in percentage row type. Percentage row type. Now I'm just going to write select star. If I'm going to row type, we will use star. So I'm just going to write select star into nm. That's it. So I'm just going to use select star into nm. Now I'm going to display nm dot enum. I'm just going to use nm dot cell. I'm just going to use like nm dot job. So according to requirement, I can display all the values. So this is what exactly the percentage row type attribute is. Percentage row type means it's going to hold the entire row. So we are using select star into nm. All the values from that particular row will get stored into the nm, and from the nm I am going to display the values like this. Run this. Yeah, we are getting a Scott, 5000 and analyst. So this is how we can use this. This is what, this is percentage row type attribute. Yeah, as such, any questions, any problem from your side, any queries? Are you getting something?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, because you people are not responding, never responding you people are. So I just get confused, like what the things is going on. The things is in right direction or not. So that's why I'm asking the question regularly. Okay. Now, the next thing is, after the percentage row type, one drawback is there with the percentage row type. And what exactly the drawback is, see, I'm just going to display the three columns over there. For that purpose, I'm using select star. Suppose in my table, we are having 30 columns, 35 columns, 40 columns is there, then what will happen? Select star means what? It's going to select all the column from the table, and you are just going to display the three. So unnecessary, the memory wastage is there, isn't it? The memory wastage is there. So this is not a good idea to use the percentage row type if we are having the large table, we are having the large set of data, because we just need to display the three or four column. For three and four column, we are using select star. So performance wise, this is not really good. So what we can do, we can ignore this percentage row type. We can use PLSQL record. Now, what exactly the PLSQL record is? PLC, because you people are from the programming background, PLSQL record is nothing. It is just like a structure of C. Or if you are not familiar with the structure, of course you people are familiar with the class and object in Java. So we can say it's like class in Java. Oh, that's great. So basically, what exactly the PLSQL record is, it's a kind of user defined data type. User defined data type. It's the same thing. Class is also, it's a kind of user defined data type in Java. What exactly the class is, what exactly the structure is, it's the same. It's a kind of user defined data type. So PLSQL record is what? It's again a kind of user defined data type. So how we can declare the PLSQL record? To declare the PLSQL record, what we need to use, I'm just going to use type T is record. Type T is record. And I'm just going to declare the variable. X is of type number, X is of type imp dot enum percentage type comma. I'm just going to use Y is of type imp dot cell percentage type. And I'm just going to use Z is of type imp dot job percentage type. And I'm just going to close this. The same way, normally we define the structure. the same way normally we define the class. So we are just going to declare the class and we are going to finally close this. So this is the class we are having, this is the structure we are having, but in PLSQL it's not a class, it's not a structure, it's a PLSQL record. Now what I need to do, after the creation of the class, after the creation of the structure, you need to define the object, you need to declare the variables for that class type. The same thing I need to declare over here. I'm just going to declare the variable P is of type T. So P is what? It's a variable. And what is the data type of P? It's a T. So I'm just going to write select ename comma cell comma job into P. From emp where imply name is equal to 7788, and finally I'm just going to display P dot X. I'm just going to display P dot Y. I'm just going to display P dot Z. This is how we can display this. If I'm going to run this, yeah, we are getting Scott, we are getting 5000, and we are getting analyst. So this is what exactly the PLSQL record is. PLSQL record, just like it's a kind of user defined data type, it comes under collection. I will discuss that. So this is how we can use the PLSQL record. The good thing about the PLSQL record is I don't need to declare the variables, and here we are just using the customize option. Like we are having the ename, salary and job, and I'm going to put this value into the P, and finally I'm going to declare the P dot X, P dot Y, P dot Z. So what we can consider just like a structure of C. That will be better. Now, one problem is there with the PLSQL record. And what exactly the problem is? The problem is right now you are just going to use select ename comma cell comma job from emp where imply name is equal to 7788. Perfectly fine. Suppose I also want to display another record. If I want to display another record, then what I need to do? Again, I need to declare the variable age of type T. If I want to display another record also, again, I need to declare the variable. So basically PLSQL record is just going to hold the single row. I want to put the multiple values. So how we can do that? So what we can use PLSQL table. What exactly the PLSQL table is? PLSQL table is just like a structure in PLSQL. It provides us array like access. Oh, that's great. So what we can say, it's provide us array like access. It's again a kind of user defined data type. It provides us the array like access, and this is again also the part of the collection. It's again the part of the collection. Collection means what? It's always dynamic, it's always generic, the same thing. So how we can create the PLSQL table? This is how we can do that. I'm just going to write type T is table of in% row type. So I'm just going to declare the table is of type. I'm just going to declare the variable T is table of in% row type. Now I'm going to declare the variable X is of type T. Nothing wrong with that. I'm just going to declare the variable X is of type T. Now we are going to use select star into what? X of 0, because it's an array, like array, it's not exactly array. So we are using select star into X of 0, and I'm going to display this like P dot.
So what is the T again, sir?
This T,
yeah, that T,
it's a kind of PLSQL table. It's a kind of PLSQL table. It's a user defined data type. So this is how we can create the PLSQL table. We need to use the syntax type. It can be anything. Type T is table of in% row type. And one important thing that we need to use over here, it's indexed by binary_integer. Because it's a kind of array. Array means what? The pocket will be there. Pocket 1, pocket 2, pocket 3, pocket 4. So we are using index by binary integer. Binary integer, it's a kind of a special data type in PLSQL. It's a PLSQL data type. We can't use this binary integer in the SQL. So we are writing type T is table of impercentage row type indexed by binary integer. Basically, this is just we are going to declare the collection name is T, and what value is going to contain? It's going to contain the entire row of the table. Now we are going to, because it's a kind of user defined data type, so I'm just going to declare the variable X of what type? T type. Now I'm going to write select star into X of 0, and I'm going to display this. So I'm just going to display X of 0 dot enum. I'm just going to display X of 0 dot cell. I'm just going to display X of 0 dot job. And again, I'm looking for the another record to display. So I'm just going to use select star into X of 1. Oh, that's great. Now it's an array where imply number is equal to 7369. 7369. So it's going to display all the value for this. So here I'm going to use the X of 1, X of 2. Here I'm going to use X of 1 like this. Suppose I'm also looking for the another record, so we can do that. I'm just going to run this, and this is how we are going to get the value. We are getting a Scott 5000 analyst. We are also getting a Smith 1800 and clerk. So this is basically what it's a kind of PL SQL table. PL SQL table, we can say what exactly is this? It's a kind of array that we can say in PL SQL. In PL SQL, we don't have every programming language having the concept of array. In PL SQL, we don't have the array as such. What we can do, we can use the PL SQL table as an array. So we are using it, provide us the array like access. It's a kind of user defined data type, and it belongs to a collection. In every programming language, we are having the collection concept is there. And in every programming language, whether it's a Java or .NET or other programming language, collection is always generic and dynamic. Generic means what? You can put any values. And dynamic means what? N number of values you can put over there. So in this table, we can put the N number of values. Important thing is PL SQL table always start from the zero, just like normal array. So this is how we can use the PL SQL table. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to create another PL SQL table that will give you the clear picture about this. It's not necessary that I'm going to put the values of the table. I'm just going to write type T is table of number. Oh, now I'm going to create the PL SQL table is of type number. And here I'm using index by binary integer because it's a PL SQL table, it's an array. Now I'm going to declare the variable X is of type T. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write X of 0 because it's an array, 100. Oh, that's great. I'm going to put the values over there. X of 1, X of 2, X of 3, X of 4. Now I want to display these values. Like we are having the array. In array we are having the multiple values, and I also want to display these values. So what we can do is we can apply for loop for I in 0. I'm going to start 0 dot dot X dot count, X dot count, and finally I'm just going to write loop, and finally I'm just going to write dbms underscore output dot put line, dbms underscore output dot put underscore line. What I need to display, I just need to display X of I, and loop, and finally I'm going to use the and run this. Yeah, we are getting the value, but here we are getting no data found. Someone can tell me like why we are getting the no data found? Because you are using X dot count. Count means what? It will display the number of values over there. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So counting will be 5. But because it's going to start from the 0, so it will go up to the 4. So I just need to apply minus 1 over there. Yeah, we are getting 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. So this is how we can use the PL SQL table. Other properties also there with the PL SQL table, like we can apply dbms underscore output dot put line. Suppose I'm looking for, I want to display the first record. We can also use like this x.first. I want to display the last record. We can also display like this x.last. First means what? It's a zero. Last means what? It's the last value. Suppose I want to remove the values. We can also use like this. I'm just going to use x.delete. x.delete. I want to delete the zero index from there. And then finally, I want to display the count, like how many records are there. So I'm just going to write x.count. So this is how we can delete the individual record, individual cell. We can also delete the entire table. I'm just going to write delete. Then I'm going to display the count. So these are the different attributes over there. First, last, count, delete. That these things we can apply with the table. Run this. Yeah, we are getting the value over here. So after deleting, it was like this. This was the first, this was the last, and after deleting it was the 4 over there. And now when we apply the final delete, only nothing is there. So this is how we can use the PL SQL table. Someone can ask you the question like, I don't want to use the delete statement, but I want to delete the values from the PL SQL table. How we can do that? My question is, by the use of delete, you can delete the values from the PL SQL table. But my question is, without using delete statement, I want to delete the values. How we can do that? Yeah, it's so simple. I'm just going to declare the variable. P is of type T. Remember, in P, nothing is there. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to write x is equal to p. That's it. I'm just going to write x is equal to p. Now I'm going to count this and nothing will be there. Yeah, we are getting zero over there.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
So let's say they deleted one row, right? Like I'm one in one value in the array. So after that, does that auto index the array or
no?
How does it work? Because
no. It's a good question. It was the good question. Okay, I'm going to delete the zero. Okay, now if I'm going to delete, I'm going to show x of zero.
Yeah.
I was expecting this question and this was really a good question. Yeah, I'm just going to make it comment so we will get the clear picture what's going on. After deleting, I'm just going to display x of 0. Run this. No data form.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's just pointing the null address, right? No?
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you.
It will never rearrange the columns and all. So this is what exactly the PL SQL table is. So PL SQL table is basically, suppose we are going to get the data from the table, like Oracle table. We are not familiar like how many data will be there. Might be the 10 record will be there, might be the 100 record will be there, might be the thousands record will be there. So how we can accommodate this record in the PL SQL? So what we can do, we can use the PL SQL table. And because the PL SQL table is dynamic, we don't need to think about that. Whatever the size of the table, it can store all these value. So this is what exactly the PL SQL table is. Remember, the good thing about the PL SQL table is it's always going to start from zero. Okay, now in the place of PL SQL table, in the place of PL SQL table, what we can do, we can also apply the nested table. Oh, that's great. We can also apply the nested table. Oh, that's good. It's basically PL SQL nested table. Remember, SQL nested table is different. PL SQL nested table is different. SQL nested table means table within a table. And PL SQL nested table, it's a different thing. And what we can say, it's like PL SQL table. Oh, that's great. It's again like PL SQL table. Okay, it's again a user defined data type. Again, it's a kind of collection. And remember, PL SQL nested table always start from one. That's the difference. It will get a start from one. I'm going to declare the PL SQL table, and type T is table of number. Here we don't need to put the keyword index by binary integer. I'm just going to write type T is table is of type number, and here I'm going to declare the variable x is of type T. Remember, the variable declaration is different over here. Here you need to use the constructor. Yeah, this is how we can declare the PL SQL nested table variable. Now I need to put the values over here. So how we can put the values? I just need to use the keyword extend over there, x.extends. I'm just going to use the x.extend over there. Then only I can put the values. Extend. We can also apply the for loop. Extend. This is how we can apply the for loop. And now I'm going to display this. Now everything will be the same. Yeah, first is also there, last is also there, delete is also there. Everything is there. Yeah, everything is just like your PL SQL table. Only the difference was, it will get a start from one. And the second difference was, this is how we can declare the variable of nested table. Run this. We are getting the message subscript outside of the limit. We need to check. Oh, because I just display the x of 0, that's why we are getting this message, because we don't have the 0 over there. So we can use 1. Run this. Yeah, we are getting the message no data found. Of course, the data get removed, that's why we are getting the message like no data found. So this is how we can use the nested table. We can comment this according to requirement. We can apply this. So this is how we can use the PL SQL nested table. And we can also use the nested table like this. I'm just going to make the group comment over there. And we can also use the PL SQL nested table like this. Control C. Declare type T is table of number. Here we can initialize the value directly. Because it's a constructor, so here we can initialize the variable. In this case, we don't need to use the extend and all. So this is how we can do this. Directly you can put the values over here. Run this. Yeah, perfectly fine. So this is what? This is your PL SQL table, nested table. It was the PL SQL nested table. Now, one important concept is there. We are having the concept of PL SQL varray. Oh, varying array. Like PL SQL table, or what I can say, like nested table. It's again a user defined data type. It's again a kind of collection. I start from one, remember. But it's a static. A static means the size will be fixed. So this is how we can do that. Type T is V array of 10 of number. Or I'm just going to use V array of 5. So this is how we can use the PL SQL V array. Here we need to define the size. And then everything will be the same. Like 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just going to give the size 4 over there. So yeah, everything will be the same. One important thing, interesting, we cannot apply x.delete of 1. We cannot apply this. It will give you the error. And run this. Yeah, we are getting the error x dot delete. That's interesting. Why it's going to give me the error? Okay, make it comment. Then do this. Yeah, we are getting the output. We are getting the output. Every output is there. And we can also apply the VRA like this, like your earlier nested table. Like we can also apply the VRA like this. Type T is, we can simply apply VRA of number, VRA of 5 of number. Oh, multiple values. Oh, I'm just going to use the 6. So this is also, this is how we can use the VRA. And we are getting this value.
So question.
Yeah, commenting. Yes, please.
The read doesn't start from 0, it starts from 1.
No, 1, 1, 1. Start from 1. Now, remember, this is the important concepts in PLSQL. And at the time of interview, the normally people will ask you the questions regarding the collection in Oracle. Remember, we are having the concept of PLSQL table. We are having the nested table. And we are having the VRA. Remember, PLSQL table can't use in SQL. We can use this in SQL. And we can also use this in SQL. We can use the nested table and VRA in the SQL. I will show you how we can do that. Remember, always start with 0. It will get a start from 1, and again it will get, it's a dynamic. It's, this is also dynamic, and this is a static. And remember, the most important thing, it's a sparse collection. That's why you can delete the record from the middle. You can delete any individual record. It's again a sparse collection. And this is what, it's a dense collection. Because it's a dense collection, that's why you can't delete the record from the middle. Because it's a dense collection. Yeah. So VRA is basically, it's a dense collection, and nested table is a sparse collection. A sparse collection means what? Suppose we are having the 5 values. One value will get a store over here, the another value will get a store over here, the another value will get a store over here, the another value will get a store over here. This is a sparse collection. But the dense collection means what? This is the first record we are having, then the second record will be in the next, the third record will be in the next, the fourth record will be in the next block, the fifth record. So this is what, this is the concept of dense collection. That's why we cannot delete the record in the middle. This is what exactly the difference between PLSQL table, nested table, and VRA. This is more or less the guaranteed question for your every interview. The question will be, are you familiar with the collection in PLSQL or PLSQL collection? Your answer will be yes. What are the collections over there? We are having the PLSQL table, we are having the nested table, we are having the VRA. And when you are saying nested table, it's not only the nested table. Always use the term PLSQL nested table. Because if you are going to say the nested table, I am going to consider like you are talking about the SQL nested table. It's a PLSQL VRA. So this is what exactly the difference between PLSQL table, PLSQL nested table, and PLSQL VRA. Clear? As such, any questions from your side regarding this? So total we are having the 11 program is there, Z11.